Today we will start the chapter number 3, that is Plant Kingdom or the Kingdom Plant Tree. Now in this kingdom, we will study about all the groups of plants, that is algae, rhyophyta, pteridophyta, gymnospermy and angiospermy. Before that, we will discuss about the different types of classification system that we have already discussed in previous videos. The system of classification, that is artificial system of classification, was that which was based upon the morphological characters. Superficial characters were taken into account, then the shape and structure of the leaf, then the shape and structure of the ambrosium, etc. And internal structure, anatomy, embryology, etc. were not included that. That's why it was known as artificial system of classification, which was given by Carolus Linnaeus. Then came the natural system of classification given by George Bentham and J.B. Hooker. They considered, along with the morphology, they have also considered anatomy, embryology, all the internal structures for the system of classification system. That's why it was known as natural system of classification. Later on, then came phylogenetic system of classification, in which the phylogeny, the phylogenetic relationship of that plant or organism with others, also included in the classification system. And accordingly, it was assumed that the organisms belong to different taxa, have similar characters, and they belong to the same ancestor. Then the taxonomy was helped by numerical taxonomy, cytotaxonomy, chemotaxonomy. Numerical taxonomy means, if we are considering the numerical method for the study of taxonomy, like the high computational devices, computers are used for the analysis of the data, interpretation of data, all the things in which each and every character of the plant is analyzed through the given equal importance for the analysis, for the classification, and that's why it is known as numerical taxonomy. Then cytotaxonomy, based upon the study of cytology, that is the structure of the cell, then the behavior of the cell, chromosome number, chromosome structure, etc., etc., all were taken into account for the process of taxonomy. Then chemotaxonomy, the chemical constituents of the cell, then the ratio of those chemicals, all these things were considered, and that's why it is known as chemotaxonomy. Then we'll now do in detail. First we'll start with algae. Now, for studying any group of plant, we have to think upon, we have to consider the main points, that is habitat, structure, size, shape, strength, etc., then mode of nutrition and reproduction. Then for that, we'll start with first the habitat. Where does the algae live? Which type of environment it requires for flourishing? So it is having algae having the chlorophyll, and that's why it is autotroph. Means they are producers. They trap the sunlight and will do the process of photosynthesis, and that's why they are known as autotrophs. Now, they are haloid. Their structure is haloid. That means they have no true root, stem and leaves, and such type of body structure is known as hallus, and that's why it is known as haloid structure. And they are most of the algae are aquatic in nature, and belongs to fresh water as well as marine water. And beside that, they can also present near the moist places. And then the structure, size and shape. Now, their shape and size vary from species to species. It is, some are microscopic in nature, made up of single cell, that is unicellular structure, for example, Chlamydomonas. And two, very complex structure, large structure, in the form of kelps, present in the giant kelps, are there, present in the marine water, and like red algae, or then paleophysi, that is brown algae, etc. So then if Chlamydomonas is unicellular structure, then some lives in colony, a group that is known as colonial structure, for example bulbox. Then some are filamentous, filament like structure, like leucocytes, etc. Then different types of reproduction, which type of reproduction they exhibit. There are three types of reproduction. We have already discussed in previous classes also, that we'll get to, that is vegetative reproduction, then sexual, asexual and sexual. Now, vegetative reproduction occurs through the fragmentation, etc. When the plant body is fragmentation, plant body is torn down into small fragments, then all the fragments will germinate, will develop into a new individual plant. That is known as fragmentation in algae. Then asexual reproduction occurs through specialized type of spores like geospores, that is motile structure having flagella. The geospores will undergo the process of germination to give rise to the plant, algae plant, and that's why it is known as asexual reproduction. Only one parent is required, no gamete formation takes place. Only through the specialized structure is spores will give rise to the new plant. Now sexual reproduction occurs, it is also reported in algae, and that is of three types: isogamous, anisogamous, and progamous. Now isogamous, when both the gametes, male and female gametes, are similar in structure, both are motile in the shape and size, also similar shape and size is there, and we can't differentiate between the male and female gametes, that is known as isogamy, and the phenomena is isogamy, and those algae will be known as isogamous. For example, maximum number of Chlamydomonas undergone by this process. Now, anisogamous. Here again, the fusion will take place by the in between the two types of gametes, but they are male and female. We can differentiate between them. Their structure and same are different. Some species of Chlamydomonas is there. Then, progamous. Third one is progamous. Here, the female gamete is born motile and bigger in shape, and the male gamete is always smaller and motile in structure, having flagella, and that means the female are the in the form of egg, and the fusion of such type of gametes is known as oogamous, oogamy, and this algae are known as oogamous. For example, bulbox, fucus, etc. will exhibit such type of reproduction. So these are all about different types of reproduction. Now, some economic importance of algae, how algae is beneficial for us, advantages for us, some important points are, because the algae are maximum in number, and in the aquatic or marine water as well as fresh water ecosystem, they are the chief producer, primary producer. They fix the atmospheric light energy into the carbohydrate, and they are the main source, food source for the aquatic organism as well as other organisms. Now, half of the total carbon dioxide fixation occurs through this group of algae. The marine algae, that is paleophycine, rhodophycine, all are there, chlorophycine, all are involved in that process. Then, some of the algae are used as food for various human people also, who are living near the ocean, like for some of the groups which are taken as food are called Phyra, Saragasm, Laminaria, etc. Then some of the algae give rise to generally the red and brown algae give rise to the hydrochloroids like algae. Algae is one of the hydrochloroids which is synthesized by the brown algae, and kerosene is made by the red algae. Then Gelidium and Brasilaria are the algae which are used for synthesizing agar. Agar is a commercial product which is utilized for the production of the culturing of the microorganisms in the lab, as well as they are also used in preparation of jellies, ice cakes, etc. Then some of the unicellular algae like Chlorella, Spirulina, etc. are used as food by the space travelers, because these are rich in protein. A very good amount of protein is present in those. That's why they are used as a food protein. Now, the algae can be divided into three classes. Three classes are there. That is chlorophycy, paleophycy, and protophycy.
In this slide, we can see the introduction, that is habitat as well as shape and size of algae. Algae found in various wide range of habitat. Mostly they are aquatic in nature. Some are fresh water as well as some are marine water also. And some of them are living other than this water, like different types of habitats like hot water spring, then ice, damp soil, rock crevices, tree trunks, old walls, then garbage pits, waste bunks, etc. So at the same time, some are free floating in nature, which are freely floating on the surface of the water, and such algae are known as phytoplanktons. Now they are having different shape and size. Some are unicellular, some are multicellular, and when unicellular, some are living alone, for example Chlamydomonas, which is microscopic structure. Then Volvox is the species which is living in the colony. Then Eulothrix is the filamentous structure. Hydrodictyon is net-like structure. Then other bigger plants, leaf-like, like Alva, Fritzschiella, etc. So in this way, they are wide range of habitat as well as different size and shape. In this slide, we can see different forms of plastids in algae. Different species of algae shows different shape of plastids. For example, some having cup shaped chloroplast in case of this Chlamydomonas and Volvox. Some are discoid in shape like Vocheria and Cara. Some are girdle shaped like in Eulothrix. Some having reticulate like Odogonium, then Hydrodictyon, Cladophora, etc. For example, Spirogyra has spiral shaped plastid, and Gygnema has star shaped plastid. So in this way, they have wide range of plastid of different in different species. In this slide, we can see different division of algae. Algae is divided into three main classes, that is Chlorophyce, Phaeophyce, and Rhodophyce. And they have different characteristic features. The Chlorophyce is the green algae, Phaeophyce is the brown algae, and red algae is the Rhodophyce. Now, they have different types of pigments, and depending upon that, their color is also depending. For example, Chlorophyce have the chlorophyll A and B, whereas Phaeophyce has chlorophyll A, C, and fucoxanthine, and Rhodophyce has chlorophyll A, D, and phycoerythrin. Then their stored food is also different type. For example, Chlorophyce is storing the food in the form of starch. Then in Phaeophyce, mannitol and laminarian. Then Rhodophyce store the food in the form of floridine starch. Then their cell wall is also of various type. In Chlorophyce, it is made up of cellulose. In Phaeophyce, it is made up of cellulose and algin. And whereas Rhodophyce, cellulose, pectin, and polysulfate esters. So in this way, their cell wall have different components, chemicals. Then the number of flagella as well as size of flagella is also varying. For example, in Rhodophyce, no flagella is there, but in Phaeophyce, the number of flagella is 2, but they are unequal in size and they are attached at the lateral side. Whereas in Chlorophyce, the number of flagella varies from 2 to 8, which are equal in size and generally placed fixed at the apical region, at the apex. Now their habitat is also varying. For example, Chlorophyce members are living in fresh water, brackish water, as well as salt water. But Phaeophyce, fresh water is rare and mostly brackish water and salty water. Rhodophyce is the same. Fresh water are very less and maximum are in brackish water as well as salty water. In this slide, we can see the reproduction in algae. Algae exhibit three types of reproduction, that is vegetative reproduction, asexual reproduction, and sexual reproduction. Then vegetative is mostly of fragmentation type, in which the thallus is breaks up into different small fragments, and each one of the fragment will develop into a new thallus. Now the asexual reproduction take place by formation of various types of spores. Some are zoospores, which are flagellated and motile in nature, whereas some are aplanospores, which are non-motile in nature without flagella. Now they are also undergoing the binary fission process, that means the breaking down of the cell, parent cell, into two daughter cell. In this way, the mitotic nuclear in which the mitotic nuclear division, that is karyokinesis, will be followed by the cytokinesis, and from the parent cell, two daughter cell will be forming. So these are type of asexual reproduction. In this slide, we can see the figure showing fragmentation. Then here fragmentation in Spirogyra. The Spirogyra, when it will be formed in the breakdown into the small fragments, each and every fragment will develop into the new individual plant. Now these are the zoospores which are coming out from this zoosporangium, and finally they will germinate to form the new algal plant. Here we can see there are three types of sexual reproduction, that is isogamy, anisogamy and oogamy. Isogamy means both the gametes are of same size and shape, and we can't differentiate between these two, and their gamy, that fusion, is known as isogamy. Second type, in which the female and male gamete have different shape and size, and their fusion is known as anisogamy. Whereas in oogamy, the female gamete is always in the form of egg, and the sperm is the smaller than the egg, and their gamy or the fusion is known as oogamy. And this reproduction, this organism having such type of reproduction, sexual reproduction, are known as oogamous organism, oogamous algae. In this slide we can see the life cycle of algae. That means alternation of generation between the gametophyte as well as sporophyte. We'll start from here. This is the multicellular haploid plant body, and this is the gametophyte of the plant. Now it will undergo the process of formation of haploid gametes, and because the plant body is haploid also, that's why no meiosis will take place, and just they will give rise to the haploid gametes by the process of mitosis. Then these gametes will undergo the process of fusion, that is fertilization, to give rise to the product diploid zygote. This diploid zygote will undergo meiosis just after then, and it will the chromosome number becomes half in the spores. So this is the spores having half number of chromosome, that is haploid structure. It will undergo the process of germination to give rise to the multicellular haploid thallus of the algae.
Algae can be divided into three classes, that is chloropicy, phagopicy and rhodopicy, depending upon the pigment present in the plant body. Chloropicy is green algae, rhodopicy is red algae, and phagopicy is brown algae. Now we will consider study different characteristics of all these three algae, then comparative study. Now, first of all, habitat. Where does this chloropicy are present? They are found. So, habitat, most of them are aquatic, very less are terrestrial also, but they used to live in moist places. Now, aquatic interface of chloropicy, both type of aquatic, that is fresh water as well as marine water, but mostly fresh water. In rhodopicy, mostly marine water, then phagopicy, mostly marine water. Now, about their structure. In case of chloropicy, the plant body is of various type. Some are unicellular, made up of single cell, which are microscopic, like chloromicrogonas. Some are multicellular, like some are living in colony group, like for example, that bulbs. Then some are having this advanced type of structure like cara. So different various types, Spirogyra. Some are filamentous, like leucothrix. So in this way, we can see different types of various type of algae. Now, in case of chloropicy, although all having the thallus, because of the algae group having no true root, stem and leaf, that's why their body is known as thallus. Here, chloropicy thallus is multicellular. Here, no unicellular members are there, and but having body organization, complex type of body organization. In case of phagopicy, here they are simple branch, some are in simple structure, some are branch, some are filamentous also, having profused branching. Some are very big in size, like different types of kelps, which may be 100 meters long also. The vegetative cell is covered by cellulose, and which is made up of cellulose, and which is covered by gelatinous seed from outside. Whereas in case of this plant, that is chloropicy, here cell wall is made up of two layers, outer and inner. Outer is made up of pectose, and inner cell wall is made up of inner layer is made up of cellulose and outer is pectose. Now, here different types of pigments are there. In case of here, pigment in case of this chlorophyce, chlorophyll A and B is present, which is present inside the chloroplast. Although the chloroplast is of various shape in chlorophyce. You can see some having this void type of structure, in some the plate like structure, some having cup like structure, reticulate, ribbon like. So, in various species, you can see different shape of chloroplast. Pyrenoids are also present in chloroplast. Now, here in Heliophyce, the protoplast contains the blastate and centrally placed vacuole as well as nucleus. The plant body of this Heliophyce consists of three parts: hold fast, which is attached to some substratum, then the stalk or the middle part is more stipe, and the frond is the callus part, which is photosynthetic in nature, which is capable of photosynthesis. Then the so these are now about the pigments here A and B. Now in case of rhodophyce, the pigment is R phycoerythrin, and that's why it appears red in color. Here pigment is, in case of Heliophyce, pigment is chlorophyll A, C, xanthophyll and carotenoids. Now, due to these different colors of Heliophyce members are there, and due to the presence of this pigment, the color may vary from species to species. Now, the stored food material here present in the form of oil droplets. In case of Rhodophyce, chlorine starch, and which is just like the amylopectin or glycogen of the complex organisms. Then here in Heliophyce, it is like the complex starch that is known as mannitol and laminarin. So these are different forms of stored food material. Now reproduction. In all the three classes having three types of reproduction, that is vegetative, asexual as well as sexual. Chlorophyce, the vegetative reproduction occurs through the process of fragmentation. Now, asexual reproduction occurs through the zoospores, motile zoospores, which are formed inside a fruiting body structure. That structure is known as zoosporangia. So, on the plant body, zoosporangia will appear, and that will give rise to the zoospores that will undergo the germination for the living development to the plant, individual plant. Now, sexual reproduction exhibits three types, that is anisogamy, isogamy and pogamy. That means in some members like in Chlamydomonas, isogamy is there. That means both the gametes are of same type, in the shape and size, we can't differentiate between them, and the fusion occurs and gives rise to the zygote, which will develop into the plant after meiosis. Now in isogamy, both the gametes are of different types, we can differentiate between these two regarding their structure, shape, etc. And in case of pogamous, the female gametophyte is non-motile, gamete is non-motile, as well as they are bigger in size and in the form of egg, you can say. And after the fusion, always the male gametes are smaller as well as motile. After the fusion, it is known as this pogamy. Now, in the same way, here, rhodophyce, three types are there, vegetative by fragmentation. Asexual reproduction occurs by the spores, but those spores are non-motile. Sexual reproduction also takes place by the gamete of formation, which is pogamous type, and here the gametes are non-motile. Some of the examples of this chlorophyce is like Cara, then this Chlamydomonas, Volvox, so various Gilothrates, so many wide range of species are there. Here some of the examples of chlorophyce is Glaciliaria, Geranium, Polycyclonia, etc. Now, Heliophyce also having three types of reproduction, that is, vegetative reproduction by the process of fragmentation, then asexual reproduction by the formation of the spores, that is, the spore structure having two flagella, biflagellate zoospores, one is bigger and one is smaller, and they are based on the lateral wall, this way. Here, say the structure is there. Now, the sexual reproduction again takes place by the oogamy, and here the pyriform gametes are two beings. Some of the members are Vitiota, Laminaria, Ceratosum, Fucus, etc. And the cells are, as we know, that they are used as a food. Now, Chlorophycin, one of the members is there, that is Para. It is assumed that Para has the economic importance because they had given rise to the senior group of plants like Bryophyta. Bryophyta evolved from the Para. So, Para is the link between the algae and the Bryophyta, bigger the complex organism, that is higher organism, higher plants, that is Bryophyta. So, this is the connecting link. This has given rise to the Bryophyta.
We can see the different economic importance of algae. Some of the algae are used as different like food, some are source of the medicine or for other uses. Maximum algae are the main primary producer of this on this earth. Algae are the main oxygen producer in aquatic area also. So we can see about the algae forms 1.6 to 15.5 into 10 to the power 11 tons of carbonic material like food. Some of the algae are used as fertilizers, like for example blue green algae, which are used as the biofertilizer because they have the capacity to fix the atmospheric nitrogen into the soil, and hence they are responsible for enhancing the fertility power of the soil. Some of the example of these fertilizers are blue green algae are nostoc, then enavena, oscillatoria, cycnonia, spirulina, etc. And then cultivation of spirulina is gaining importance nowadays as feed for fish, poultry, cattle, etc. In this slide we can see algae is a medicine. So many group of algae or species of algae are utilized as the source of medicine. Some are also play an important role in indicating about the pollution, then in the association with the fungi. Then role of algae in industries, we can see they are the source of agar-agar, which is very important commercial material. It is utilized in the laboratory for the culturing of microscope in the studies. At the same time, these are also utilized for making jam, jellies and ice cream, etc. And some of the source of these agar-agar is the red algae, and the some of the species are Geladium, Gracilaria, Pterocladia, then Gigartina, Ceramium, then Chondrus, etc. Now, algae are also utilized in sewage disposal. For example, Chlamydomonas, Chlorella, Euridina, etc., which are living in sewage water and mainly utilized for releasing oxygen and modify the carbonate material into nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium fertilizers. Some of the algae are utilized in pisciculture field, and they provide food for the fishes. Some of the green algae, diatom, some blue green algae also used as a food material for the fishes. They are also making the water clean by releasing oxygen. At the same time, some of the algae like spirulina are utilized as food by the space travelers because they are rich in protein.